I wanted to do something that would give my life meaning. From a very young age, we're told to make sacrifices, we're told to compromise, especially in our society. We never take time to self-reflect. We never take time to think about our well-being. And in this process, we lose ourselves. We lose our self-identity. So I had my entire life planned out. I wanted to get a high-paying job. So at the age of 10, I got braces. 50,000 rupees for braces, and that was 13 years ago. So I knew this was the job that I wanted. Money, 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 cha-ching. So I wanted to be a dentist, and I wanted to do my BDS from LUMS. It was later that I realized that LUMS does not offer BDS, so it was back to square one for me. Sad life. So I did my O-levels, and then I did my FSC. If any one of you has done their FSC, especially after O-levels, you know how hard it is to balance your studies and your life. So I went into a spiral. It was a very dark time for me. All the confidence that I had gained, it vanished in 2 years. So this was the state that I was in. Constantly worrying. And so, when I was about to give my MCAT, I was very depressed. I had no idea. I couldn't even fathom the thought of being rejected. So I did not give my MCAT. And till this date, whenever anyone asks me, why did you not pursue medicine? I always tell them one thing. It's because I never gave my MCAT, so you never know, you know? So it's okay. It's just between you and me. It was on purpose that I didn't do it. I started making excuses for myself to comfort myself. I told myself that it's okay. I told myself that that it was the fault of our education system that focused more on retention rather than the concept. I blamed the timing, so excuses, excuses all around. So even when it was time to apply to different universities, I had to give my SATs. But I did not. Why? Because I wanted to have that excuse with me all the time. Whenever someone would ask me that why did you not apply for so and so young university? So yeah, so that one dream that I had to become a dentist, to be a doctor, it all crumbled down, it all fell apart. And during my initial years in Kinnaird, I felt very hollow, like I had no aim, like I had no ambition. So I even loved playing basketball in school. But over here, we have some amazing basketball players, and I was scared. And I was scared to try because I thought I was not good enough. So, do you see a pattern here? I never gave myself that opportunity to even fail, to even try. And I owe myself an apology for that. I'm sure half of the crowd here has given up on so many opportunities that I cannot even begin to tell. And you know, it's easy for us to make excuses because our society isn't exactly kind. We love pulling people down. So this was a time when I started becoming passionate about photography. Now, some people find solace in their diary, but I found my solace in my camera. Whenever I used to bring that lens up to my eyes, and you know that moment you get when you capture, when you freeze that moment and you can relive that moment again and again, that is what I found from my photography. So, photography. It's something that gave me passion again. This was a time when I said, I will not put labels on this. I will not get into my head. I will continue this. But as years progressed, it came back all down to this, that I could not do it. Because people started noticing my work and they did express how confident they were. They thought that I could make it big in this field. But then there was this voice inside my head that kept telling me that I'm not good enough. No matter how hard I tried, no matter how much I experimented with my photography, whether it was starters or whatever, because it was exacerbated but through social media, because I started judging my worth through the amount of likes on the pictures that I would get on my Facebook, on the pictures that I posted about my photography. And so, I became anxious again, because because I lost my purpose. This had a direct impact on my frame of reference, because initially I used to take pictures for the love of art, but now whenever I used to bring that lens up to my eyes, I envisioned only the approval of horde of faceless people. So I started making excuses again, and some of my common excuses of not doing work were, I'm sorry I don't get permission, I'm sorry I have a test tomorrow, I'm sorry I'm leaving for another city. And one of my main go-to excuse was just me not replying, was just me not seeing those messages, the one that I'm most known for. You know? So one day I knew I had to, you know, you can't push someone if they don't want to be pushed, and I never wanted to be pushed. But there was this time in Kinnaird when I said, no, I have to do something. I have to do something related to photography. I need to get that ambition back. So I went to New York, I applied, I got in, and I did a photography course over there. We used to get assignments every day. One class led by Vivian, she asked us to take self-portraits. Excuse me, the entire reason for me being a photographer was so I could hide behind the camera and not be in front of it. I did not want to roam around New York lugging around my tripod. Honestly, because of the way I feel about myself, the entire process was very cringeworthy and uncomfortable. So, nevertheless, I did do it. The first picture, basically these self-portraits were supposed to show our state of mind. This first picture showed how self-conscious I am about my looks. The second picture depicted the chaos and confusion in my head. And honestly, the third picture that I took, it was a random shot that I just needed to complete the assignment. This one. So when the day of critiquing came, one of my classmates said that maybe Maham looks down upon herself, like she's not good enough, but she has the potential to reach the skies. And that can be depicted by the building. And that white thing in the puddle, that's her hope. And honestly, this was our second class together. And she said something, she made me realize how I've been feeling for the past 22 years. For the past 22 years. And honestly, I felt very vulnerable at that time. My mind is equal to balloon. So, I realized that day that I had a ton of such pictures. Then came our second year of graduation, our Active Citizens Project by British Council, where we were supposed to basically have a social action project. And for the first time in my life, I had no excuse that I could justify. Now I had to do something. Now this was my opportunity. It not only knocked on my door, but it pushed its way in. And I had to do it. In fact, some of my seniors told me to do the bare minimum to get it over with. But my friends and I, we had something else in mind. We had no clear goal, we had no clear ambition, we did not know where we were going to end up. But we had a plan, we had this drive inside of us to do something. So our project was Autism Awareness. And we put our heart and soul into this. We devised an entire plan for giving lectures, we painted a wall of awareness, we went to malls, we gave workshops in schools, taught teachers how to be more sensitive and more patient when interacting with the students, or how to make schools more inclusive. To us, that was it. That feeling of content that I got, it was amazing. I cannot even begin to explain it. A few months later, I applied for an international study visit to showcase our project. Passed the written application, but I botched the entire telephonic interview. I swear, 5 minutes before the call, I actually puked. That's how anxious I was. 5 minutes. A year later, I decided to apply again, but this time without having that fear of failure. Like, this time I wired myself to think that this is a part of my learning curve, and it's okay if I fail. Because I've never given myself that opportunity to fail, and it's okay if that happens. And I went in, gave that call, got selected. So over there in London, I met a lot of like-minded people. I met them from different countries, we exchanged our ideas, we talked about our about the things that we could do. All of these people were from different countries, working in their respective countries, trying to make a change. And when people like that come together in a room, magic is bound to happen. They share the same vision as me. You know you're doing something right when your passion rubs off on other people. So there were, I'm still in contact with two different people who I'm collaborating with now on my project, and then they're sharing the same vision, we're sharing our details, we're sharing information on how to make sure that autism awareness is not only in Lahore, but all over Pakistan. So this was more, this wasn't only about personal growth. We managed to do good work regarding autism. And honestly, I never believed that this project could propel me to go abroad, or I never imagined myself doing late nights or talking to strangers about this. In the truest sense, it does start with you. Six of my friends and I, we started this project a year ago, and now it has reached global exposure. There are people around the world who have been very touched by this project. So it does start with us. There are great thinkers who say that to begin something, you need to have an end. You need to have a clear goal. But honestly, I've learned something different. If you have a drive in you, if you're passionate about something, whether that's photography or anything else, whether you have, when you have that, and if that drive is a drive to do something noble is great, then there's no need for fear. You are going to overcome it. And then you can do this. And you need to believe in yourself. Do not let anyone's criticism hold you down. Emphasize on self-improvement. You're in competition with yourself, nobody else. People will always hold you back, whether it's intentional or unintentional. Never listen to it. All these experiences have led me to open up. And over the year I've had, I applied for the post of HECR, which is equivalent to the student body president. And I did win, but this win wasn't just a win for me, but it was a win for everyone who thinks that they're not good enough. I overcame my biggest fear of speaking. So do not wait for opportunities, because not all opportunities are as evident as this. So even before this TED talk, I was very nervous. And all the things that could go wrong. So the next time you feel, so I developed a system for myself, and it can work for you too. So the next time you think you're not good enough, or you feel like you just need that little push, just ask yourself three questions. Question number one, is this going to help people? If this will, then do it. Not for yourself, but because you owe people that. They deserve that. Number two, do you really want to do this? Are you going to regret if you pass on this? So don't overthink, then just do it if the answer is yes. And number three, my favorite and most important question. What's the worst thing that could happen? If you crash and burn, people will forget about it. It will be old news next week. But if you succeed, you'll make your mark. You'll make that impact. You'll make that mark that you were born to make. You're going to succeed. And that impact is not going to be only for yourself, but that's going to carry on, and that's going to be for everyone around you for years to come. So overcome your fears to achieve your full potential. Start with yourself. Thank you.